We was talking about Crazy Joe. Crazy Joe. What you know about Crazy Joe, bro?
It was a monster.
A little more than that, though, bro.
Yeah, man.
That's like saying, what you know about Al Sharpton? It was a black man.
That's right. I think he was responsible for some other shit. His name came up a few times, like, you know, with a lot of other people. Right. Not too much, I know.
That's crazy. I came a long way in weight, bro. I've never done that shit in a few fucking years. But nah. That's all you know about Crazy Joe? You know Crazy Joe was putting niggas on, right? That's why they didn't really like him too much, because he was putting niggas on. Mulianos, you know what I mean? Them niggas, yeah, he was putting the African-Americans. He wasn't fucking with his kind. Once he got bagged up, he started fucking with the niggas in prison. And then when he came out, he started making them niggas family and shit, you know what I mean? So who knows? Crazy Joe probably might got a lot to do with other shit down the lines, huh? Brooklyn nigga. You're a Brooklyn nigga, bro. He ain't from Philly, he ain't from Jersey, a Brooklyn nigga. And Crazy Joe was Crazy fucking Joe. He was fly, he was flashy, like, you know what I mean? He do wild shit. Nigga go to court with the fucking Ray-Bans on, you know what I mean? Like, yo, what's your opening statement? The carpet look good enough to play fucking craps on this shit, like, to the judge, bro, with the fucking Ray-Bans on, my nigga. He ain't take them shits off, bro. He was a crazy nigga. Nah, he was different. He was, and you could see it was it the niggas rubbing off on him, son?
Was that the reason why they called him crazy?
Because he was, you know, that nigga was tied in with them niggas, and then he got with some niggas, and then, you know what I mean? But the other Italian niggas wasn't really fucking with that shit. And then when he dissed Russ, that shit was crazy. That shit was crazy, bro. For those that don't know, we talking about the movie Irishman, you know what I mean? Crazy Joe's one of them niggas. This shit right here could be like a 10-part fucking, because it's a lot. It's a 3-hour film, bro. How are you going to chop that shit up in like 10 minutes? You can't review a 3-hour film in 10 minutes. It just dawned on me, son.
I said, this is going to be a little, we're going to be on this for a little bit.
For a little while. I want to talk about Star Wars too. Why are white people so obsessed with fucking incest? But that's a whole different conversation, man. Stick a pin, bookmark Irishman. It's coming right back, real quick. Matter of fact, pause it. Yeah, it's going to be easy for you. Because, you know what I mean? Irishman, I got shit for days. Star Wars, I'm a chop. Bro, you're taking this character a little too serious, my nigga. Nigga's like, I can't. I don't have teeth. Like, yo, you see this nigga's teeth on the bottom row. So, keep it in the movies, man. Keep it in the movie. The best part of those movies was the interaction with fucking Al Pacino and fucking Robert De Niro. When the nigga came to the nigga and was telling the nigga, like, yo, niggas want you to chill out. Nah, that was beautiful. That was fucking beautiful. Like, you know what's ill about movies that niggas go off script, they be ad-libbing and improv-ing, bro? It feels like you're right there, son. Ain't no fucking script with... Script is respect life, my nigga. You see how them niggas go back and forth? That's a script, son. The way how Al Pacino and Robert De Niro was going back and forth in that fucking scene where he was getting an award, and pretty much it is what it is. That was what it was. It is what it is. That's all they kept telling the nigga. It is what it is. He's a me? Yo, my nigga. Yo, bro. Irishman is definitely ill, my nigga. You're going to fall asleep watching this shit. There's no way in hell you're going to watch a whole 3-hour film. Nah. But every part, just make it like a 2-day fucking series episode, adventure shit for yourself, my nigga. And you know, I'm going to say that later, boy. Nah, I ain't done yet. But word, that movie, the dynamic between all three of those characters, it really shows, like, shit. Either Scorsese knows what the fuck he was doing, son.
The characters, you mean like in real life? Mm-hmm. Like, because
they all got a rapport with this nigga. Like, that's their mans from way back yonder. Especially Robert De Niro and Scorsese. Them niggas damn near started out together. Scorsese was making the movies. That nigga was the actor. He was putting that nigga in the shit.
De Niro, right?
Nah. Yeah, De Niro. Nah, yeah. Nigga Pacino fucking put on mad weight. You know who could have made that movie a little bit better, though?
Who?
I think his name is Christopher Walken.
Oh, the King of New York?
Yeah.
Oh, that... I don't know, but...
He could play a fucking gangster, though, nigga. He got the eyes, the whole attitude, the look, the other nigga, but I was like, nah. He just looked like a fucking mobster. He don't really act too well, though. Ray something. He was in Goodfellas. The nigga with the dots all over his face and shit. You know who I'm talking about, bro.
I know who you're talking about.
Yeah.
He played Henry.
Know what I mean? But I'm like, nah, Christopher Walken with a fucking... bodied one of them shit, son. Like, that shit got me thinking, like, who the fuck is Joe
Pesci? But to see Joe Pesci.
Joe Pesci's family of people is connected to shit like that. Because Joe, he plays it a little too well. You gotta keep in mind, we're younger. We're not as old to know the younger Joe Pesci. So he might have been playing roles like this. I was introduced to Joe Pesci as a funny guy. Comedian nigga, funny nigga. Yeah, I've seen Casino and shit like that and fucking Goodfellas. Nigga, I was introduced to Joe Pesci on Home Alone, bro. That was the first time I seen a nigga.
Oh, Home Alone?
Yeah, bro. Yeah, funny nigga. Seen him in other shit. I'm like, yeah, this is kind of weird. Like, are you a comedian nigga? You playing this little monster shit? I guess. But as a younger nigga, I didn't appreciate. I appreciated the funny shit when I was younger. Seen Lethal Weapon. I'm like, all right. As I got older and I seen these movies again, I'm like, yo, Joe Pesci kind of really... Like, nigga, Goodfellas, I'm never gonna forget that whole made men shit. He wanted to be a made man so bad.
Niggas Goodfellas is one of my most favorite movies.
Stop it.